And for more on Australia's reaction to the royal engagement, I'm joined by Philip Benwell, the national chairman of the Australian Monarchist League. Philip, obviously in a new sense it's overtaken us, but how will the people of Australia generally react to this news?
Well, my reaction is from 4 o'clock this morning is that people are tremendously interested. It's taken us by storm, really.
We've already seen that William and Harry are taking the whole royalist image to a younger generation. Will this further enhance the monarchy with young people in Australia?
Undoubtedly. I mean, around 60% of our members are young people under the age of 30, 35, and there is tremendous enthusiasm in the royal family, and you only have to look at the Facebook pages to see how the reaction is.
Will it change the general attitude towards our monarchy?
I think so. It's bringing it close to home. I mean, the royal family is there for all people, whereas if we had the marriage of the son or daughter of a president, it would be entirely different.
The Prime Minister, Julia Gillard, is on record as saying that she would see a useful time for a changeover between monarchy and republic here in Australia at the passing of the Queen. Does this give new life to the monarchy as an Australian institution?
Oh, yes. Yes, it does. Well, we only have to look at the visit of Prince William earlier this year and to see the tremendous enthusiasm, the crowds that came out, even though it was really a private visit, and the number of young people who came out to cheer Prince William.
Prince Charles has had, well, can I say, limited popularity with the Australian people over the years, whereas Prince William is immensely popular. Is there any possibility of a leapfrogging in ascension to the throne?
Well, I don't think so. I think Charles will become king, but we have to look at his reign as preparing for the reign of William. I mean, the kingship is a tremendous burden on anyone, and who would wish that on a young person? Let William enjoy his life. Let him enjoy his marriage. And of course, when Charles becomes king, William will become Prince of Wales, and that will prepare him for the burden of becoming king. And his reign will be a new age. Totally different from the reign of the Queen, and Charles will prepare William for the new age.
Do you see the Queen as ever stepping away from the throne, or will she stay there?
No, the Queen has said that she cannot abdicate. Her coronation oath is a lifetime oath,
yes.
and she's not able to abdicate.
Lovely to have your insight here this morning. I appreciate it very much. Philip Benwell.
Tremendous, thank you.
From the Monarchist Association of Australia, thank you very much.